The relationships that Darwin saw in the diversity of living species led him to his theory of evolution. They also led observers to the common properties shared by all living things, and these are complexity. This means more than an intricate organization of parts. In life, the parts are constantly changing. The changes themselves are complex, highly ordered, and regulated. So complexity is therefore a dynamic organization of cellular components, the components of life. Homeostasis refers to the ability of cells and multicelled organisms to maintain stable internal environments in the face of environmental, chemical, and physical challenges. Maybe I should be clicking here. There you go. So homeostasis is a property of resistance to change. Reproduction is, of course, the one obvious prerequisite of life. Remember the statement from cell theory, cells come from pre-existing cells and not from spontaneous generation. Growth and differentiation, or development, are also obvious events. Fertilized eggs multiply and differentiate into tissues and organs. But even the lowly single-celled bacterium can grow and differentiate to a certain extent. They can become spores under adverse environmental conditions, and then can resume an active bacterial lifestyle when conditions improve. We can look at these transitions as the forerunners of the more familiar growth and differentiation I just noted. Irritability simply refers to the fact that living things are excitable. When stimulated, physically or chemically, life responds. Of course, doing anything, including living, requires energy. Finally, evolution is itself a property of life. All species evolved, and all living things are subject to natural selection and further evolution. So these are then the traditional properties of life as they are defined in most textbooks.